Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. After 3 years with no launches, SpaceX launched another Falcon Heavy yesterday with the USSF 44 mission.
5, 0, liftoff.
The center core was expended for extra performance. However, the side boosters which launched this mission, B-1064 and B-1065, both landed successfully for the first time on the pads at Landing Zone 1 and Landing Zone 2.
There we heard the call out that the booster entry burn has begun. Looks like the ice on those cameras are now clearing.
TY and NY FTS have saved. All vehicles continue to follow nominal trajectories.
So that re-entry burn has concluded. We're expecting the landing burn to begin in about 30 seconds. The entry burn intended to slow the vehicles down significantly as they re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. Amazing tracking cam. Views of the boosters as they return to landing zone 1 and 2. We can see the grid fins there.
Both side boosters transonic. Stage 2 FTS is saved. Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
We can see those grid fins steering the boosters for a precise landing. Again, we're attempting
landing.
Landing zone 1 and 2. At landing zone 1 and landing zone 2. What an incredible sight. With these two side boosters, this marks the 150th and 151st overall successful landing of an orbital class rocket. This is the 21st landing at landing zone 1 and the 4th landing at landing zone 2.
I wanted to share this tweet from Eric Berger following the Falcon Heavy launch. He said SpaceX has now launched its 50th rocket of 2022. Consider that it took nearly 8 years from the debut of the Falcon 9 in 2010 to reach launch number 50. We can hopefully expect another Falcon 9 launch tomorrow. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Hotbird 13G is scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 3rd at 3:24 a.m. UTC, or today, Wednesday 2nd at 11:24 p.m. EDT. I wanted to share this super cool picture posted on Twitter by SpaceX. You can see a Falcon 9 preparing to enter the hangar as Falcon Heavy leaves the other side. They said as Falcon Heavy rolled out, two Falcon 9 first stage boosters arrived at the hangar. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site and the crane was moved to suborbital pad A. There was an article posted with information from NASA about Starship and Raptor. In reference to Raptor development, it says they build these things very fast. Their goal was 7 engines a week and they hit that about a quarter ago. So they are now building 7 engines a week. Christian Davenport posted a series of tweets with information from NASA about Starship. The first says NASA's Mark Kirisich tells a NASA advisory committee that first flight of SpaceX Starship with Super Heavy booster is now scheduled for early December. Next, he said SpaceX will do a lot of test flights of Starship, including an uncrewed landing on the moon before landing astronauts there, Kirisich says. But the first time it will dock with Orion will be on the Artemis 3 mission in lunar orbit. Then, his final tweet says the first flight would be suborbital with Starship landing off the coast of Hawaii. Eric Berger posted a tweet about this information from NASA on Starship too. He posted a picture and said some detail from NASA on the steps remaining ahead of SpaceX's first Super Heavy flight test. Talking about Starship, Eric Berger posted another tweet with information from NASA. It says, a senior NASA official said this week that SpaceX has done very well in working toward the development of a vehicle to land humans on the surface of the moon, taking steps to address two of the space agency's biggest concerns. Yesterday, SpaceX cryo-proof tested the Starship 25 prototype for the first time. SpaceX recently did some Booster 7 liquid oxygen tank testing as well. So it looks like there may no longer be any Booster 8 testing or flight, as Mary posted this picture on Twitter of the prototype heading to the rocket garden. The Booster 9 prototype was seen fully stacked inside the Mega Bay recently. Taking a look at the road and beach closures, they used the closure on Monday for Booster 8. Then they used the road closure on Tuesday for testing of Ship 25. There is also another possible closure for today, Wednesday 2nd, with the road already closed as of recording this video. With only Starbase Live content this video, I have to say thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.